Hey you folks, Species 7 here. Welcome back to the channel. If it's your first time, thanks so much for stopping by. Hope you enjoy what you see. We are going to get these fields baled today. We're on the Arches map, version 1.3. And, we almost got off to a much rougher start on this map than I thought. One of my viewers left a comment this morning. Oh, I see. Okay, that doesn't actually attach to anything. There we go. About not having carrots, onions, sunflowers, etc., etc. And I came back and checked and realized that, wowzer, neither do I. Now, I thought at first maybe some of it was greenhouse, but I mean, obviously sunflowers aren't. But no, it turns out that the multi-fruit that's offered, or that comes with the map, I think it's multi-fruit _arches or something, doesn't actually give us everything we need. Once I added the multi-fruit standard and extended, then I actually got the other crops to show up, although there seems to be some sort of overlap, so I will have to straighten that out. But, big thanks, buddy. Because we would have gone to put crops down and found that we only had the standards. That wouldn't have been good. I've already missed out on a map that supposedly had carrots and onions, and we couldn't do anything with them because they wouldn't appear. Well, they're still not, actually. I didn't see carrots and onions, but we'll get to it. Anyway, maybe they're on the potato harvester or something. Oh my. Am I going to have enough to actually pull this thing? Holy. There we go. Now we're getting some speed up. Is I just sitting here spinning my tires? Do I? Now, there is a trailer that actually hooks up to the back of this baler, and we do have it. But on this initial small field, I think I'm going to actually just pack them up and drop them. And we'll worry about the trailer when we get into one of the larger fields. Okay, now, I don't imagine that this is actually going to drop them until it gets two or three in the hole, right? Oof. Sorry about that. Thought it was back a little further. Yeah, looks like we're going to need two in the machine, probably, and then one to drop. So, that's another reason I didn't really want to drag the trailer around. I looked at the field and went, well, yeah, if we make five bales, that means two of them are going to get loaded on the trailer. So, that is the thing with square bales. Seems to take a lot to build a machine, man. So hopefully, we're going to get everything straightened out with the crops. Now, I'm thinking this might actually be an opportunity, since we never got to use them, to steal the specialized carrot and potato harvesters, or onion harvesters, from the Gifts of the Caucus map. Because, like I said, I never got those fruits to work there, so we kind of got ripped off. Let's just shut that off for a minute and get ourselves turned around for this last head row. There we go. Well, yeah. Kind of weird, wasn't it? Yeah, it's the one where I backed up and forgot I was actually spitting straw all over the room. Ah, well, let's take the fat side. We'll come back and clean the other one up later. Now, this one should actually produce a bale. Well, at least when we get turned around on the other row, we should produce a bale. And let's shut her off and get turned around. Oh, there's a bale. Woohoo! Turn her back on. There we are. washed out green on this, isn't it? Looks like it's in need of a fresh coat of paint. So I guess we're gonna end up doing a lot of logging type stuff on this map by the looks of things, with the various pallets, etc. that need to be built, and a fair use for wood chips, etc. So yeah, we'll have to think about that. We do have some reasonably good logging gear. We just need the money to buy it. But after this bales, I think my next... the next thing we need to actually be looking at here is getting some grass. And it looks like... excuse me. Maybe above field 6 might be the grass area. We'll have to check it out, but we definitely need grass. And pretty ricky-ticky quick, too. This isn't something we can put off for a very great length of time. But we have our mowers, and... not sure. I think we'll probably for the grass, I'm thinking we're going to end up putting it into a loading wagon. We'll see. I don't have either yet a loading wagon or a tedder, so we're going to have to figure something out here for grass right quick. Well, we're getting a few more bales than I expected. Maybe I should have dragged the trailer. Maybe I should. Seems to all of a sudden pick up speed when you get about 75% of a bale into it. I'm not sure why that is. Well, it also misses a little spit when it fires a bale, or did I just simply drive around it? That's a possibility. And that's it. Well, I see it's a little more than I was going to give it credit for. That's for sure. And, of course, a lot less than we're going to require. Alright, so... do we have a spit-me-out? Let's shut her off. Lift this. Ooh, we do! We have an unload baler. Nice. Well, let's do that. Alright. And let's fold her up. Perfect. Okay, so it just spits the last one. We still got a full bale sitting inside of there. And it's got these two down here. So not bad. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What do we get? 7 bales? 8 bales. Nice. That's well, there you go. It would have been exactly one trailer full. And I don't know that the trailer that we have, actually, that you can run it by itself. I think it's actually got to be hooked behind this. Because I think it actually feeds right off of there. That tray, as opposed to picking things up off the ground. So, it's going to be interesting. Alright, well, we will deal with it. Not a bad bailer. Well, that's the Fendt 1290 SXD, everybody. It'll be here all week. Okay, so that's done. Now, we're in the wrong piece of kit now, aren't we? Sure. Sneaking through the trees. Let's go grab our Fendt. Do we have... Yeah, see, this is the bale trailer. And yeah, it's, as you can see, it tucks up underneath the baler onto that hitch and then gets it directly off the bale feed. Yeah, Black Sheep Modding did that one up. And good job. Now, the Fendt 716, I think what we need to do here, I have a pallet fork. I don't actually have a bale fork. That, as we call in the farming business, is not good. So, we will have to deal with that right quickie here. Right quickie. I have no idea where I've left the bits that make it a front loader. I think they're over around the corner. Well, they're around some corner. There they are. Nope, that's the mowers. Good, good. Alrighty, keep going. There we are. No, that's one of them mixer sheds. I know I got some parts, man. What the heck did I do with them? Oh, are you serious? What the heck? Come on now. Oops. Oh, no wonder. My fault. Yeah, that gets annoying after a bit. All right. That makes more sense, don't you think? I don't know. Without that poking off the front, we should be good. Yeah, that's gonna get old. But I really like the tractor. I suppose I could load it into the editor and blah, 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 but boy, oh boy, I'll tell you. The hue and cry that gets raised over certain things makes me worry about getting stuff in other than the stock colors. So, yeah. There we go. Get that in there. Now we need to go buy ourselves. Pokey. There we are. Alright. It's functioning. Perfect. D. Full speed ahead. Oh, I guess I could have gone out that way. Probably. You get a little bit of frame drop here and there on this one, I'll tell you. And yeah, the dirt and terrain made no difference, unfortunately. Too bad. This would be a great candidate for that mod. Well, who knows, maybe Scooby Penguin will decide to update it with such a thing. If he does, hopefully he'll add a working multi-fruit module. Alrighty, as you can see, we're certainly nowhere near capacity. Okay, I've got the skid steer, I've got all the pallet for that. So, don't happen to have a pallet fork down here. What the heck is that? Oh, that's for the skid steer as well. No. So, let us entertain me. I don't have the CSZ stuff loaded, do I? Nope. Okay. Oop. Did you forget how it works? Yes, I did. Alright, $600. Okay. Surprised they found a place to put it. I wonder where it was. I'm probably parked on top of it. No, I'm not. Well, doggies. Yeah, oh, there it is. That wasn't nearly as hard as I made it out to be. Yeah, you just gotta like look over your shoulder. Oh, look, there it is. This is the start of row two, I guess. Try to get a little straighter. Save me the issue of perhaps cartwheeling my tractor. There we go. Now, I think that little trailer will take bales. Oh, that's so freaky that you can start driving while he's still climbing in. I love it. It's the only thing that makes that part of it worth it. Alrighty, here we go. Whoop. There we are. Now, well, let's pull it clear and then we'll worry about fighting the camera. And I won. Yep, I fought the camera and I won. Alrighty. Oh, I forgot to turn the traffic on. Oops. Sorry about that, guys. We will do that. Remind me. I think there was a front loader once that actually worked, that you could pick something up and then it actually lifted it right over the cab of the loader and you could dump it in the trailer behind you. Yeah, it was kind of cool. But, oops, where are you going? wacky. Better hope you can get back out of here again. You're gonna look like an idiot. Well, guess what? It's idiot looking time. Oh no, there's a way out here. Ay, ay, ay. Okay. Now. Oh, maybe I had to do that while this was still hooked up. Maybe, yeah, that's the deal. So, let's, 7, 8, 9. That should give us pretty much, ta-da, a flat cart. Perfect. Or not. Because I do believe this also has a bale lock on it. It's more for transporting palleted goods, but it is a universal trailer. It is from Maru's site, by the way, if you guys are looking for it. I don't think I've put it into the links. But then again, for this early on in the series, I think I've got lots of mod links there for you guys to play with. We don't all have to run exactly the same gear anyway. Well, it's not exactly on there, but this is FS-15 science, not rocket science. Oh, sure, now you slide all the way on when you're only inches away from where I'm going to want you to come off. Sure. That's really awkward. I cannot see the edge of that trailer. Yeah, looks like we're okay. I don't think anybody does this anymore, do they? In Farm Sim 15? Loads the bales one at a time onto a trailer. I think everybody's using auto loaders by now. Oops. I'll get you a little bit level, shall we? Darn again, it's really hard to see the edge of that trailer. There we go. Perfect. Dang. You'd almost think I knew what I was doing. Yeah, you're like, oh yeah, yeah, you gotta get out there and actually look at it, do you? Yes, I am that impressed. Alright. But something that I want to try. Let me go grab another bale here. Oops, there's one right there in front of me. My guppies. Look at that. No. It's the other way, dude. I want to try this, thingy. Aren't you glad I cleared that up? Where are we here? Bale shredder dealy duty. There we are. This thing. That's a bale master. Sure it is. Now, does it have some capacity or am I going to just end up spraying straw all over God knows what here? Alright. Of course, the other question is, does it require anything else? There's a thought. Let's get down here and have a look. Nope, just straw. Okay. I thought maybe you'd have to put diesel in it or something to make it go. You know, I mean, it's not unreasonable. A lot of these machines require a power source. But I take it this guy is electric. We've simply plugged him into the outlet. Alright, so... It's got a button, but how do I make it go? R? No. B? No. F1. Oh. Oh, look. Oh. Ooh, yeah, that looks like it would tear it. Oh, sorry. Tear it. Where'd it go? Oh, man. What? Oh, here, I was so looking forward to getting pulverized and it did the magic thing on me. Oh, you bugger. Alright, so now this is going to tell us we have some straw. Status. Balemaster is running. Okay. We got 4%. Right on. So, do I turn it off again now? Okay. There we go. Hey. Okay, and that's the bale barn. What is this one for? Grass bales? Oh, yeah. Alright, bale master. Yep. Neat. Alright, well, I wanted to try those out. I'm going to just simply stack the rest of them on the trailer, and we'll go from there. But, yeah, I wanted to see how that thing worked. That's pretty darn cool, man. Pretty darn cool indeed. Alrighty. Nice bit of kit. Alright, back to work. Enough slacking off, gaping at things. Yeah, we're, right, Ricky Quick here, gonna have to get some, Vother happening. I think next episode we'll see if we can't dedicate at least a little bit of it to making the animals yappy. Yes, indeed, because there's nothing like yappy animals. Nothing at all. Ba 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 ba. See, I guess it'll hold 8 bales. I suppose you could stack them higher, but I don't know if the lock works higher. In fact, I don't know if it works 8 bales or only 4. That it's more for transporting pallets of goods, Maru's boards, things like that. That looks a bit high. And it is. Get down there. There you are. Nope. Uh-oh. We got one of these bales. There we go. Oh, come on now. Why? Alright. This thing's got a little bit different reach than I think. Alright. Now I'm going to put this one on and then we'll try the script on this trailer. Just to see. How we do. How am I for lined up? Looks not too bad, actually. Eh? Not too shabby. All right. Now, of course, this doesn't have any sort of unload script either, so you do have to take everything back off by hand. Let's hope everything doesn't flip up into the air. Oh, no, so far so good. Let's get back in. And let's see what it tells us. Bail transport mode on off 4. Oh, I see. All right. There we go. I'm jolly impressed. Alrighty. Okay, why is... Oh. I did not realize that. Okay. There we are. I was trying to lift my front forks and nothing would happen. Whoops. Oh. Yeah, nothing would happen. And here I'm jacking the trailer up and down into the ground. Oh, I'll tell you. There's always an opportunity on the farm to make something harder than it should be. And if there's anyone can find it, it's me. Alright. So, good-o for you. You're going to give us a little bit of straw. Sure, I have enough room to work here. There we are. Now, let's go back again. And let's do the bucket-a-bucket-a-bucket-a. No, no. There we are. Keypad 4. And... I kind of think I prefer them to just go straight down at that point, you know? Maybe you can just sort of lay them on the sides there and have it go from there. Alright, so let's try opening them properly. There we go. That's what I want to see. Beautiful. Again, if you guys do like this trailer, it is available over at Maru's site. And that, I think, is going to do it, guys. Hope you enjoyed the episode. I'm going to unload these bales into the back of the shed here somewhere, and we'll make use of them at our leisure. So, there you go. The baling is done. I just got to pick up two or three more, I guess, and bring them over. And I think I'll probably throw a couple more into the straw ripper machine here, because we are going to need a critter or two's worth. So... carry on with that. And well, as usual, feel free to like, share, and subscribe if you have not already. And until next time, this has been Species 7 for Farm Sim 15. Thanks again for all your support, guys, all your help, suggestions, figuring things out, all of that. Take care of each other, folks, and ciao for now. Yeah, these are the last three. We might as well just scoop them up.